render your video, let's have one last check on your audio to make sure it's ready to go. At this point, your audio and video should be synced together, having visuals and narration working together to make sure your message is clear to your viewers. There are a few audio enhancements you may consider trying if you haven't done them already. First is using a background noise removal tool to clean up any background noises, like sounds from your heating or cooling system, the hum of overhead lights, or any other consistent sound. If your video editing software doesn't provide this option, it's something you'll want to do before bringing your audio into your video editor. Next, if your audio was recorded by multiple people, or in multiple locations, or across multiple sessions, you'll want to make sure you level out your audio. Leveling your audio means that you're adjusting the loudness of each clip to give them a consistent volume level. This is important to do so that your viewer doesn't have to keep adjusting their audio to hear the narration or to keep it from blasting too loudly. Finally, you'll need to decide if you're going to use music as part of your screencast. Music can be great for helping to establish a feeling or mood for your video. Down below, we provide a list of some of the places you can go to acquire music for your screencasts. While music can have a really great impact on any video, it does have a few drawbacks to be aware of. First, if you're adding music, you need to make sure that your narration isn't overpowered by the music. You'll want to find a balance between being able to clearly hear your narration and knowing that there's music playing. Like several other effects or enhancements, the viewer shouldn't really know that it's there, while still making it impactful. If your music is too loud, it will be distracting to your audience, and usually it will diminish your message. Second, you'll want the right music for the right mood. For instance, it would be inappropriate to play a happy, upbeat song in a video about cuts to job benefits. Make sure the music matches the tone that you want to set. Third, make sure you have the rights and permissions necessary to use any music or sounds you put in your video. It's tempting to pull in your favorite song, but don't do it. There are a number of sources where you can get music that is available to use for your projects. Using music that you don't have a license to can cause a variety of problems for you and your organization. As we wrap up, your audio should be ready to go. Next, we'll look at a few recommended steps to take before rendering and sharing your video, including things like getting feedback and making your video more accessible.